Hi friends, in this video electric traction 1 will be discussed, and the first topic will be systems of electrification. The first system of electrification is direct current system, where the direct current is used to electrify the system. And the second one is single phase low frequency AC system, where single phase is used and which is used at low frequency high voltage. And coming to the third system, this is a three phase AC system. Here also low frequency is used with high voltage. And the last one is composite system, where AC system and DC system are combined together to frame the new system. And there are some advantages of this composite system. That's why we have gone to the composite system. Let us see how these things are actually exists in India, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of these systems, and currently which system is using, and what is the advantage of that system, and all these things will be discussed in this video. So the first system is DC direct current system. In India, the electric traction started with this DC system only. So the first electric traction in India is with DC system. So the voltage used is 600 volt to 750 volt. This is used for urban system, where the frequent stoppages and startages are there. So this is very much advantageous for urban system. That's why they have used it for 600 volt and 750 volt for urban systems. And the second one is, they have used the same thing for mainline systems also. That means it is having long distance services. So the voltage is somewhat higher. It is 1500 volt to 3000 volt. So the examples have been given for in India. The examples are for 1500 system. The routes are from Bombay VT2 Igatpuri and Bombay VT2 Pune and Bombay to Virar. These three are the 1500 volt systems. And coming to 3000 volt system, this is from Howrah to Burdwan, but it has been already converted to 25 kV AC system. Maybe there are some problem in this, so that's why it has been converted to 25 volt AC system. So for a clear understanding, let us see the routes from which place to which place these things have been erected. This is from Mumbai, Bombay to Igatpuri. Now this is called as Mumbai. So this is the line. So it is around 2 hours 42 minutes of line. And this was erected with 1500 volt. And the second one is Bombay to Pune or Bombay to Pune. And this is around 3 hours 32 minutes of time. So the next one is Bombay VT2 Virar, and this is Virar is above, and this is 1 hour 41 minutes of journey. So this is also with 1500 volt. There are three routes from Bombay to, one is to Virar, and the other one is to Pune, and the first one is Igatpuri. So these are the three routes erected from Mumbai. And the final one is from Howrah. Howrah is Burdwan. Howrah to Burdwan. This is 3000 volt supply. And the time is 1 hour 46 minutes. So these are the things actually erected with DC system. After, of course, this particular route from Howrah to Burdwan is shifted to AC system now. And what is the contact system in this DC system? Let us see. The contact system is called third rail type. For voltage, for less voltage up to 750 volt, third rail type is used and above 750 volt overhead type is used. And these two things will be discussed in some other video. And the next one is the contact system is fed from the substations. Yeah, these are spaced at 3 to 5 kilometers for urban and suburban services, and for other services, that means mainline services, it is from 15 to 30 kilometers. We need to erect a substation. So this is the main disadvantage in DC. Okay, we will discuss those things in disadvantages, but this is the basic concept. I need to erect one substation from here, and there should be some other substation after 3 to 5 kilometers. And yeah, substation receive power from three phase supply. This, as we already know, that we can receive a single phase or three phase supply, and this is three phase supply has been given to the, we can take the supply, three phase supply, from the utility, and the substation also receives the same three phase supply. Now we need to convert this, so the substation has, it should contain transformer and also a rotary converter or mercury arc rectifier, then only it will be converted to DC. Yes, the input to the substation is three phase AC, we need to convert it into DC supply. So before that, I need to use a transformer. As the utility supply is very high, I need to step it down and then I need to convert it to DC supply. So these are the equipments the substation should be contained. Yeah, these substations are obviously automatic and they are remote control substations. So that is, in this case, there is no problem for DC supply. So these are the contact system maintained with DC supply. Yeah, the main advantage of DC supply electrification traction is, yeah, DC series motor, one of the best series motor, one of the best traction motor is DC series motor. It possesses very good speed torque characteristics, and let us see them. Yeah, it has high starting torque for a given armature current. It has small weight per HP, and it has a lower maintenance cost compared to AC series motor, and it is capable of attaining high acceleration and retardation rates, and it is suitable for urban and suburban services where high more number of stoppages and startings are there. So as the DC series motor can give high starting torque, as it can give the high starting torque, obviously the acceleration will be higher and retardation is also higher. Because of higher acceleration and retardation rates, we can use them for urban and suburban services, because in urban and suburban services we require high acceleration and retardation rates. So this is the advantage of DC supply system for electric traction. So what are the disadvantages of this system? It has high cost of substation because we need to use rectifiers here in addition to transformers. Substations have to be provided in shorter distances. So for, we have already discussed, for urban and suburban systems, I need to maintain a substation for each 3 to 5 kilometers. And for this, for mainline services, I need to maintain substation in between 15 to 30 kilometers. So that's why I need to provide substations for shorter distances only. So I need to erect more substations, which increases the cost. So this comes under one of the disadvantages of DC system. The next one is, a negative boosters are needed to reduce the corrosion in underground pipe work. There is a corrosion in underground pipe work, so that can be removed by using negative boosters, but obviously this is an extra equipment we need to install, so definitely the cost will be increased. So that is the one more disadvantage from DC supply system. Now let us move on to AC system. This is single phase low frequency AC system. The low frequency is used in AC series motor because to improve the performance, commutation properties. For if it is low frequency, the commutation properties will be improved and the power factor will be improved and also the efficiency will be improved. So these are the advantages of AC series motor with low frequency. Now the AC series motors are with 300 to 400 volt. They will operate at 300 to 400 volt, but we are getting very huge voltage, maybe 11 kV or 33 kV. So definitely we need to erect transformers all there. Yeah, in order to achieve the maximum economy, so single wire system of 15 kV, 16 and 2x3 to 25 cycles are used with return through the rail. So these are the things for AC series motor. We need to use these things: 15 kV, 16 and 2x3 to 25 cycles per second. So these are the two frequencies. In between these two frequencies, we need to operate the system to get the more economy. Next, high supply voltage, which reduces the current and hence high supply voltage. As we are provided with high supply voltage, then the current will be reduced. As the current reduces, the impedance drop will be reduced. So the substation space can be increased. So I need to erect the substation from 50 to 80 kilometer. So this is a huge distance when compared to DC system. So this is one of the advantages of this type of AC system. Next, yeah, substations. Coming to substations, if the traction system is supplied exclusively, for example, for the substations are supplied only for the traction system, the substation is exclusively for the traction system, then there is no need, no difficulty in getting 16 and 2x3 to 25 cycles of frequency, because in this case the substations are transformer substations. Simply I can use the transformer and I can get these things very easily by using frequency converter. Next, but if I use the same thing for with industrial frequency network, I need to use frequency converter in addition to the transformers. In previous case, the frequency converter is not required because as that system is used for traction purpose only, so we can convert the frequency and then give it to the transformer. But here we are utilizing the substation with industrial frequency system, then we need to step it down by using a transformer and then we need to use a frequency converter to change the frequency. Yeah, now let us discuss what is meant by frequency converter. Frequency converter is a synchronous motor alternator set which takes the power from three phase supply and supplies a load of single phase. This is the advantage of this. This takes the supply, three phase supply, and supplies load of single phase. So this is called frequency converter. The advantage of this system, frequency converter, is it avoids the unbalancing load. If there is any unbalancing load, three phase supply is directly given to the three phases or with three loads, then if there is any unbalance, that will reflect into the supply. But as we are using frequency converter, it will convert three phase into single phase. So there is no question of unbalancing load. Yeah, coming to contact system. Each locomotive carries a step down transformer to reduce voltage from 15 kV to 300 to 400 volt, suitable for AC motors. As we have already discussed, for AC series motor, the input voltage should be 300 to 400 volt, but the available supply is 15 kV. We have already stepped down to 15 kV from substations, and that supply is given to locomotives, where locomotive carries again the step down transformer. The 15 kV is stepped down to 300 to 400 volt. Yeah, speed regulation is achieved by applying variable voltage. Definitely, if we change the voltage, we can get the speed regulation. Yeah, for this purpose, on-load tapping gear is used to ensure that supply to motors should not be interrupted. Yeah, here we have used online tapping gear. That means we can change the tappings to vary the voltage, such that one condition should be there, the supply should not be interrupted. That means the supply never be zero, so we need to take care of the contacts properly. Yeah, at a time two consecutive contactors are closed and voltage impressed on the motor will be the average of these two contactors. So this is the system we are using for single phase AC with low frequency. Yeah, coming to three phase AC systems, the three phase AC, two overhead conductors will with rails form three phase supply. That means there should be two overhead conductors and the railway track will work as a third conductor, and that will be given for the induction motor at 3.3 kV and the frequency is 16 and 2/3 cycles per second. Yeah. There is no need of transformer at locomotive, as induction motor directly can be given to connected to 3.3 kV, so you can directly give the supply to the induction motor without any transformer at locomotive. That is one of the advantages with three phase AC system. Yeah, coming to advantages, the high voltage supply which reduces the current of operation. Okay. Yeah, robustness and trouble-free operation of induction motors. So this is very very important advantage of AC system, because here we can use induction motor. Induction motor means this is famous for robustness and trouble-free operation. Yeah, induction motor has automatic regenerative braking without any additional apparatus. This is also one of the important features with induction motor. Yeah, coming to disadvantages. Yes, induction motor don't have the high starting torque. So this is one of the disadvantages. Let us see the other ones. Yeah, two overhead conductors feeding system become very much complicated at crossings and junctions. Especially in crossings and junctions, the overhead conductors has to be twisted, and in junctions they have to be make it up and down, such that the other conductors may not be connected. So with this there is some disadvantage. So that comes under disadvantage of AC systems. Yeah, constant speed characteristics of the induction motor is not suitable for traction work. Traction work means I should have starting, I need to start quickly, I need to with good acceleration, and with good retardation, I need to stop my train, and then I need to again start my train, and again I need to stop my train. This is the situation for traction work. But in induction motor, the speed characteristic is almost the constant, so I am unable to change it make it suitable for traction work. So this is the disadvantage with induction motor, and that's why this is disadvantage with AC systems. Yeah, it has speed torque characteristics similar to DC shunt motor, so it's not suitable for parallel operation. Yeah, the speed torque characteristics of induction motor is similar to shunt motor, so it's not suitable for parallel operation. So in this, the induction motor is may not be suitable for traction work, as the speed characteristic is almost the constant and the speed torque characteristics is approximately equal to shunt motor, so it's not useful for parallel operation also. So these are the very disadvantage points from induction motor. So obviously it's from AC systems. Now that's why we look at composite systems. So we can conclude that no system is giving good results in all aspects. So definitely we need to club them. So composite system combines any two of these systems and it will give you some good results compared to the previous ones. At present there are two systems, and let us look into them. Yeah, there are two systems using presently. So they are Kando system or single phase to three phase system or single phase to DC system. Single phase is advantageous because it is carrying only one conductor. In three phase we need to carry two conductors. So the disadvantage of three phase is, as we need to carry two conductors, it is very disadvantage when there is a crossing or a junction. So we will take only single phase, and three phase has some advantages. So single phase is converted to three phase and getting the advantage of three phase, and DC system has some advantage. So the single phase is converted to DC and getting the advantage of DC system. So these two are the systems. Let us see the advantage and disadvantages of these two systems. Yeah, this is Kando system. This is from single phase to three phase system. This system is developed in 1932. So let us see what exactly it contains. It contains 16 kV of 50 cycles single phase overhead supply being converted to three phase supply by means of phase converter equipment carried on the locomotive. So in each locomotive the phase converter system is carried and that will be converted 16 kV 50 cycles per second system single phase system to three phase system, getting the advantage of three phase. And this three phase supply is fed to three phase induction motor. Yeah, then what are the advantages and disadvantages of this scheme? This scheme has advantage of get rid of complicated two overhead conductor system replaced by single wire, as we are using single phase system to take the supply. Okay, and disadvantages, the drawbacks of induction motor, obviously as we are using induction motor, it has low starting torque and it has high starting current, absence of speed control, as we can't control, as this is the almost constant speed characteristics, so speed control is obviously almost absent. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of this scheme. So what are the latest inventions? Yes, with the development of silicon controlled rectifiers, and those are used as inverter, so it is possible to get variable low frequency supply, say half to 9 cycles per second. So this is very low voltage. We can obtain this much of margin with inverters using SCRs. So these are the very good invention from power electronics. So SCRs are invented and that was used as inverters. So with these inverters we can reduce the frequency and we can reduce the supply voltage also. So at this frequency, the induction motor develops high starting torque. So without excessive current, as the frequency, as at this low frequency, the starting torque is very high for the induction motor. Speed control is easily obtained by varying the supply frequency. Here, speed control can also be obtained by varying the supply frequency. Yes, frequency can be easily varied by using the inverter. So, we can do it very nicely. Yeah. Yes, this is the second thing. So, single phase to DC system. Let us see. Yeah, this system of traction employing 25 kV 50 cycle system, and this will be used for all future electrification in India. Let us see why. Because it implies overhead single phase 25 kV 50 cycles, which is stepped down by transformers in locomotive. So locomotive is having transformers only, and this is simply stepping down from 25 kV 50 cycles to required voltage and frequency. And this single phase AC is converted to DC and is used to drive DC series motor. Okay, and the these are the employed systems in India. Yeah, this is a very important thing, as we know that our system is three phase system or single phase system, but obviously the AC system. But in AC, the motor used is induction motor, and as we know that in induction motor, the speed characteristic is almost the constant, and that is a very good drawback for traction work. And we also know that DC series motor is the best motor for traction work. Then how can we utilize the supply provided, the supply available, that means AC supply, and the motor available, that is DC series motor? How can we club them? That will be clubbed like this, simply stepping down the voltage by using transformer and converting the same AC supply into DC by using a rectifier, and that will be within the locomotive only. So this system is one of the best systems so far invented, and these systems are already employed in these routes. The route is Howrah to Tandla, Igatpuri to Bhusawal, Virar to Sabarmati, and Madras to Tambaram. Let us see all these routes also. So this is main thing, main important and the advantageous things. As we have already discussed, we are getting three-phase supply. Yes, taking three-phase supplies has some disadvantage, as we need to carry two conductors, overhead conductors. So we are taking only single phase supply, and that will be converted to DC, as our most favorable motor is DC series motor. Let us see these routes. Yeah, this is Howrah to Tandla route, and this route is having 19 hours 32 minutes of route. So this is one of the longest routes so far we have seen. And the next one is this route. This is Igatpuri to Bhusawal route, and this route is having 5 hours 5 minutes route. So this is also one of the longest, and this one is also very good, longest only. This is from Virar to Sabarmati. This is 8 hours 51 minutes of long, and this is small only, this is not lengthy, but it is from Madras to Tambaram, so it is 1 hour 5 minutes or 1 hour 22 minutes of long. So these are the routes till now we are using. Yeah, now let us see, once we have already covered all systems, DC system, low frequency AC system, I mean single phase system, three phase system, and also composite system, let us discuss the difference between pure AC and DC systems. Let us quickly see them. Actually, there are only 9 points. We have already discussed all points, but let us write in a systematic manner. Yeah, the first point is DC series motor. It has more starting and also running torques, hence it can provide the high starting acceleration. So this is very much important for any traction system. Yeah, now number of speeds in case of DC series motor is very less. If we use chopper control, we can have so many speeds. So the controlling is very smooth. That means for small things also, we can get small points also by using chopper control. But if we don't have chopper control, our number of speeds are limited. So we can't get more number of speeds. But in AC series motor, by using tap changing system, we have so many number of speeds. Okay, but this is disadvantage of DC, but now it is also rectified by using chopper control. That is once again thanks to power electronics. Okay, next point is DC series motors are less costly, lighter for same HP, more efficient and less maintenance when compared to AC series motors. So this is one of the good points from DC series motors. Yeah, the next point is regenerative braking, which is more efficient and has less complications in case of DC systems compared to AC systems. Yeah, more elaborate negative boosting is required in AC systems to that of DC systems. Okay, due to high impedance track in AC system, we need to provide negative boosting. Okay, next point is number of substations for a given distance will be less with AC and it will be more with DC. As we already discussed, for DC system, for each 3 to 5 kilometers we need to erect a substation for urban system, and for each 15 to 30 kilometer we need to erect a substation for mainline system, and that is 50 to 80 kilometer for AC system. So obviously the number of substations for AC system is less compared to DC system. Yeah, overhead distribution is lighter and less costly in AC system to that of DC system. Okay, for overhead lines, it's very less costly for AC system compared to DC system. Yeah, AC system is obviously there may be some interference with communication lines. Of course, this was eradicated just by reducing the frequency, but there is no question of interference with communication lines in DC system. So coming to a rail conductor system, actually we have already discussed a overhead distribution system. So that is very less costly in AC system, but rail conductor system, this is very less costly is possible with DC system to that of AC system. So these are the main difference between AC system and DC system. So if we summarize all these points as a table, so the table looks like this. First one is the character or the parameter, and the next column is DC system, next column is AC system. Obviously the starting and running torques are more in DC system, less in AC system. Obviously the acceleration is more in DC system, less in AC system. Number of speeds are less in DC system, more in AC system. Cost, weight, maintenance, all are less in DC system, more in AC system. Efficiency is more in DC system, less in AC system. Regenerative braking is efficient and easy in DC system, but it is somewhat complicated compared to DC system in case of AC systems. Negative boosters are not required in DC system, but they are required because of high impedance track in AC system. So the number of substations are more in DC system, number of substations are less in AC system. overhead distribution is costly in DC system and it is lighter and also less costly in AC system. Rail conductor system is less costly in DC system and it is costly in AC system. Interference with communication lines is very low, obviously zero in DC system, and it's very high in AC system, obviously with when compared to DC system only. Okay, so these are the comparison between these two only, DC system and AC system, that's all. Because as we have already reduced the supply, the interference with communication lines is almost reduced. Okay, so these are the complete explanation of system of electric traction. Obviously there are four systems and the advantages and disadvantages all are discussed, and finally the comparison also discussed. So if you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video, please share with your friends and family. And if you please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I like to complete the utilization of electrical energy within 2 to 3 months. So please subscribe to my YouTube channel and please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. Thank you. Thank you very much.